So, welcome you all you to the volatile talk in Japan. I hope you can hear me. Well, the basic idea behind volatile started.
Oh.
Yeah, you see how this works. As all the started things. So volatile started. It's more or less it's live during a discussion where Martin Joy Schulze and Jesus Clement were part of, and they discussed, well, how should virus scanner be updated during such a stable? Because our stable release policy is more or less just says, well, we won't update things except there are security bugs. Of course, it's not totally true. There are some other situations where packages can be updated, but it's not possible, for example, to bring really improvements in, but just to fix RC bugs. And, well, a virus can not recognizing some virus types is not RC buggy. It has important bugs, but well, they won't be updated and stable. And during the discussion, volatile archive section, volatile, was proposed. And the basic idea was to say, well, packages in that section get easier update rules in stable. But, well, you all know how Debian works. Usually nothing is done until one does it. So, yeah, we saw it decided, was so the idea was modified a bit in the way that we said, well, first of all, we start with an extra archive, volatile Debian.net. This has also the advantage that we're not bound to use the deinstall times. So, but if we have an update, we can just install it right now. So it's in the very, very same way as security Debian.org works. Yeah, so that was the beginning of the discussion. Very soon, the first package for Woody was updated. That was a Whois package. Whois had, yeah, well, no security issues or so, but just it couldn't work with the .org domains. For .de domains, it could just tell if the domain is connected, but not who owns it, which is, of course, both not, well, not, there's no security issue in it, but it's not too nice to work with such a package. So we updated a Whois package. Now, but for Woody, we all knew that volatile is more or less just we were trying to set the technical infrastructure right so that we know how to do it, to look how the lines and up sources should look like, and so on. So for Sarge at least, we made some, well, we updated some things. We have now in up sources list, it's a very nice line, how it works. If you want a package, you can write deb http volatile debian.net and debian volatile. And here you just write, well, you know, for security, you write something like sarge updates. Here you write sarge volatile and the components you want. So, and now for Sarge, we started with the first package to accept as GLAMAV, the virus scanning engine. And what happened in the success, what happened shortly after accepting GLAMAV, was that we were hit by a lot of mirror requests of people wanting to mirror volatile. Except Africa, we have now a mirror in Antarctica. We have now a mirror on every continent of the world. In some continents, more than one. And we have a lot of positive feedback. What I really expected was with GLAMAV that we will get some negative feedback to say, oh, you jumped too far, because basically we took a new GLAMAV version, but we modified the packaging to the old version so that the packaging is the same, so that the change of behavior is only to detect the new virus. Yeah, but the user side was way more positive than we ever expected. So that worked fairly well. We had now the second update to GLAMAV. Second update to GLAMAV is really only a security update. So we had a nice chance to learn how to deal with the security team, how to work with CVE IDs, and all that stuff. And as the result is, it worked pretty well. We had good experiences with security team, But good experiences in our case means we were able to make sure that the security team updates a package for Sarge at about the same time as we pushed out the volatile package. We just had to deliver the security team all the patches they needed and the CVE IDs, but then it worked good. Also, the volatile team learned one thing. We needed a non-public contact address that we can give the security team, the maintainers of packages we have in volatile. I think I should now say something about generic, how packages go into volatile or what they are supposed, what the guidelines for package are supposed to be. First, the most important thing with volatile generic is that we say, first of all, it must not break anything. From the administrator's point of view, using volatile should be as simple as using security. That also means there's not just some new code coming in, not just a new program coming in, no new dependencies. But it should just work as before, but with the bug fixes, of course, fixed, or with the detecting new virus patterns, detecting new ways. If we speak about something like Jack Rootkit, which is discussed currently, with checking new ways to hijack a computer or whatever. The second basic rule is we do packages only in cooperation with the Debian maintainer for some very good reasons. The one reason is, of course, it makes our life much easier. It makes our life easier when it comes to what do we really need. It makes our life easier in the case there's some security update like we had it with Glamav. And it makes our life easier because we say we must be able to use the Debian bug tracking system for volatile. So if there's any issue, users can just report the bugs as usual. And the maintainer needs to agree, of course, that we can use the Debian bug tracking system for that purpose. But in the end, it's for everyone easier to use that one than if we would do an extra bug tracking system for the few packages we have. And of course, we also definitely want that the upgrade from Sarge plus volatile to Edge is as good working as a direct upgrade from Sarge to Edge. And if we have the maintainer in the loop for it, and the maintainer says, yes, he will make sure that it works, then of course, it's way easier than if it's just a random collection of backports. That leads me to the next topic. Volatile is not just a backports collection. We really aim to make sure to say, okay, which, first of all, the question, if one asked, can we do an updated package of something? The first question is, do we need it? Which bugs are going to be fixed by it? And unless there's a very good answer that says, this and this important bug are going to be fixed, the default answer of such questions is, of course, no. And if somebody says, I need a backport of something, there are lots of good sites with backports. Backports.org, for example, that's not the aim of volatile. There are, however, packages where we say, okay, we really see the need to put them into volatile, but where at the same time we say they are too much changed to put in the usual volatile packages. And for those packages, we have a section called sloppy, so volatile sloppy. Yeah, well, if someone has a better name, please say it. We had a discussion on the mailing list for about 2 weeks where everybody says the name is not good, but nobody had any other idea. Or there were some ideas, but we all agreed that any other idea is even worse. So if you have a good suggestion, please come up with it. We can still change it. In the sloppy section, there are larger updates. And also, the sloppy section is done in a way that apt doesn't use it automatically. So you have to pin up the packages you want to have. If you will do an update in the sloppy section, we will put a code snippet for up preferences into the announcement, so that people can just cope with that snippet and get exactly the package they want to have from volatile sloppy. We're currently discussing Brandon was suggesting during another talk that we put an Xorg server package into volatile, sloppy. That would be a new package, so definitely not available for normal volatile. But on the other hand, it would allow a lot of new hardware to work, and it would work together with the current Sarge X client packages. And Brandon said he promises that it will upgrade painlessly to Edge. So on these conditions, we are currently considering whether to put it in volatile sloppy or not. But there's currently not a decision, and decisions are usually done after we see the package, not before, because we are, of course, keeping care of a lot of small technical details of such a change log, and also for us other things important, like the change logs should really say what I changed. Things like backported features from your upstream version is definitely not enough. Oh, I've seen a lot of change logs that way in Debian. Yeah, so I think that was now most of the very important, or most of just an overview, how volatile really works. And I guess there will be some questions. I can already see Franz starting with it. So please go on, Franz.
I'm wondering what the reasons are to put something like X on volatile, even if it's volatile sloppy. Why not just on backports.org? Because if you start doing that with volatile, I think you're going to be... you're going to put in danger the concept behind the real volatile. I think you should be very careful with that.
Yeah, Franz, I definitely agree that we need to be very, very careful with that. So that's the reason why I said there's no decision. We started consulting it. I think consulting it is not really wrong. If the maintainer says he would be willing to do the work. And what I definitely would refuse, for example, is an updated X client package or something like that. What Brandon said, it would only be a new X server and nothing, not X base or so. And I think that might work, but I'm really not sure. And I have a bit of bad feeling about that in my stomach. I agree with you. And usually I listen to that feeling, and I probably just need some more days to really come to a decision that says either yes, we can do it, or no, we should not. But I definitely agree that X, it's definitely at least it's a borderline, but I'm not sure on which side of the border it currently is.
It's also very easy for a maintainer to say, now, yes, I promise to make sure the upgrade path will work, but will he still do so in 1.5 years' time when we're going to be releasing Edge? And I think for packages that have fairly regular updates, like Clamavé, it's much easier to keep the provider involved to make sure that the upgrade path will work than with updates that are basically done once or very infrequently. The provider may just forget he's on volatile, may lose interest in that part, and he may start to think about it as just another backports.org. I really think you have to be very restrictive with volatile and only do it for the packages that have like data updates with security implications, stuff like that. The Whois packages is also a good example. Things just stop working if information like that is not up to date.
Yeah, well, I see the same problems as you do. So of course, I need to be careful. I'm not going to say, well, we will reject it right from here, because I'm really especially for such decisions, I'm a bit slow in deciding things, because I really want to think them through and discuss them with other people. But I definitely welcome your input on it, Franz. We will do a decision soon enough. And I also see all the reasons you said as very important reasons what's against accepting Xorg.
I have a question, but who do I ask about adding a package volatile? Because I sent a mail to, I think it was the message, there was some sent to Devel Announce or something about this, and I sent a reply to that address, and I never got a response about adding a package volatile. Who do I contact?
So the basic role that for Debian Volatile is Debian Volatile, it lists Debian.org. That has also the advantage that a lot of people see it. I have seen sometimes requests directly flooding to my private address, especially there were some requests during about the same time as Sarge was released. And I'm quite sure that I forgot to answer to some of the mails. But if you wouldn't use it at that time of the day, it was about 10 hours of the day reading mails, answering mails, and pushing package in and out of Sarge. It happens. I'm very sorry for that, but it happens. And the role address has a large advantage that there are more people reading it. And some people who are just saying, well, there was a mail. Don't you think you need to answer it right now? So please write anything to that mail address. And of course, what we want to have in the initial mail is we want that the maintainer writes it, not just somebody else. And we want to be sure to know which are the basic functionalities that got missing during Sarge, and that should be re-added. And and something about how large are the changes. If it's a change, a small diff of it or whatever, so that it really can work or start working on an informed position and not have to guess around. Okay, so next question, please. Hop.
We are wondering that we might have to update Kopete during the time of Sarge lifetime because all these proprietary instant messenger protocols will change during the Sarge lifetime. However, the problem is that Kopete is part of KDE network, which is a very large package. Do you think that we should prepare just a Kopete only upload for volatile or just upload the entire KDE network with the backports of the protocol fixes?
Well, all this proprietary instant messaging stuff is really a pain in the ass.
I agree.
So just to make sure that we all are on the same position, I'm definitely very opposed to upload something like KDE network to volatile to update one part of it. That's because I really think, it's too large, or there are too many things that are uploaded, and if you only change one of them, you might perhaps be better in a position where you upload a source package that only builds the parts you really need. But what I can say already now is that such an update won't be too easy for all sides to handle. For all sides means for the maintainers, for the volatile team, whoever else is involved, because it's really a very, very difficult thing. And I also think we will have to learn something for volatile during Sarge lifetime, and that is if we already know beforehand that we have certain packages that are going to be updated quite often, like we know for the instant messages, we should perhaps start to separate them into source packages before we release Edge, so that it makes our life, at least during Edge's relief cycle, easier. Also, we should try to separate data packages from source packages if it is possible, even if it's only a single data file, but if the data file needs often updated, the binary file not, it might be worse to do it, because if you have it separated, it's way easier to make sure that we didn't break anything. So yeah, I think that would be a bad thing to happen when we have to update things like game and so on. Yeah. So next question, please. Oh, yeah. Here. Okay, next question then on that side again, please. Unfair to zoom on sleeping people.
So the volatile archive was created to work around the staticness of the stable release. Do you think it's a good idea to have the current policy on the stable release? Do you think we should update with the newer kernel drivers and newer X drivers so we make sure the stable release is installable on newer machines, like the entire life cycle of a stable release?
The answer to that is, I don't consider volatile to be a workaround. I consider, well, but if you want to have something change in Debian, it doesn't change because someone says, hey, it's a good idea, or usually not. Usually it changes because someone starts implementing it. So we said, okay, we will implement now volatile, and I hope to get enough feedback, or that we get enough feedback, so that the stable release manager can reconsider whether it's a good idea to include the volatile packages in the stable release or not. Like, for example, the security packages are included, and perhaps, well, of course, I'm quite sure that we accept only packages that are okay from the viewpoint what should be included, but it's not our call in the end to make. But of course, the goal is, of course, that the volatile packages are included in the stable release in the same way that the security updates are included. But there is still a long way to that. And of course, yeah, there are different opinions how it should work. And you usually convince people to show that your way works better than the other way. And that's volatile Debian.net does try to do. Okay, some more questions? Otherwise, please hand the microphone back to you.
Yeah, one other thing. There are plans to make Sarge CDs with packages merged from volatile. Do you think that would affect the perception of the stable release?
I don't think that this one would have any effect on the stable release. When it would be really interesting, but I said, well, I would say probably we won't do it. Would be if we would add a newer kernel series and make a new installer with it. But what I understand from Troy Hess, he would very much prefer to not do it for very obvious reasons, because it's not too easy to do it. But yes, but I really think it's a good thing in Debian that we can just try or work on implementing something, show that it works. If it works, we can just merge it back in the proper Debian. And that's what volatile is about. That's also what a lot of other stuff that happens in Debian is about. That somebody starts to work on something, shows that it works, and we merge it back into Debian.
What I like about the concept of volatile is that it offers users a choice if they want to stay with the basic stable release or go an extra step further. I think basic volatile could be included maybe in point releases, but on the other hand, what's the point? Because the nature of the basic volatile system is that it's going to change very soon afterwards anyway, again. So as soon as you release basically a point release, it's going to be out of date again. So it's not, you don't gain that much if you include the package in volatile on a point release. It's different for the sloppy archive, but I really think that users should have the choice to have it included or not. And that would go against including it on point releases.
Well, for sloppy archive, I definitely agree with you. Well, for the others, it depends. For example, the Whois update that we did to Woody, we just need to update Whois once. The newer Whois updates were not as important as the one with the .org and the .de registries. So, for example, that one, in my opinion, really would have made a good match to get into the last Woody point release. So I think sometimes it really helps. Of course, with Glamoth, I expect too many updates, so probably for that, you are partly right, because even if you update it in the point release, then you have a very more recent have very much more spam patterns that they can use, or virus patterns that they can use than if it wouldn't be updated. A word on how Glamoth works, perhaps. Glamoth has a data pattern and program code for the data patterns, and from time to time they update or they add a new variant how the data patterns look like. And the block and if you have older program code, the newer data patterns are just ignored, and Glamour gives out a warning to say, I'm too old, use something newer. So yeah, so even if you wouldn't have the very recent ones, but just more recent ones, it would be better since you have the very old ones. So I think even that would make sense. But yes, well, and it's definitely not very, very high on my priority list to get that thing done. And I personally expect that there will be no change for Sarge with a stable release policy, independent how well or not volatile works. But if volatile works well during Sarge, I think that's a topic that we will discuss for Edge. So we have enough time to really decide if it's a good or bad idea. Okay, next question, please. Okay, so in that case, I think we're done for now with the talk. Thank you for coming. And I can see the later in the week the talks are, it's harder to get here. So thank you very much for getting up so early. I know how hard it is, so thank you very much.